Hello everyone. My name is Piyush Gupta, and today I will be talking to you about open source at DigitalOcean in general. What is our philosophy, and how we are giving back and contributing back to the community. A quick introduction about me: I work as a senior developer advocate with DigitalOcean. In my previous avatar, I have worked as a developer, where I created platforms based on cloud-native technologies and also helped customers move their workloads from legacy infrastructure to cloud-based infrastructure. Right? I'm an active contributor to Kubernetes Sig Contribact. That's short for contributor experience. You can now find me on Kubernetes Slack. My handle there is Benson91. You can also reach out to me on Twitter with the same handle. And if you are the kind of person who would rather write down an email, please feel free to shoot one at pgupta@digitalocean.com. Right. To give you an overview of DigitalOcean, we started this company in 2012 in New York City. And since then, we have raised more than $450 million in funding, both equity and debt. Majority of the revenue comes from international markets. And when I say international, I basically mean outside of the United States. We have more than 500,000 active customers, and a big majority of them are SMB. That's short for small and medium businesses. We have got 13 data centers across the globe. And the one thing that we, especially proud of ourselves is our community site, right? And we have a huge repository of tutorials, blogs, question and answers, right? And we get more than 4 million plus visitors there per month. Now, talking about the basic philosophy, right? And we believe that anyone can become a software developer, right? The way internet has reached everywhere, the way communities have come up, you have got videos, blogs, tutorials, and everything, right? You don't need a formal computer science degree just to be a software developer, right? You just need an idea, a problem that you would want to solve, right? And you can just get started with that. And cloud technologies have helped a lot in that movement, right? If you look back, right, during the old days where you would have to set up a whole data center, manage that data center just to get an application up, right? And it used to take months, right? And then to virtualization platforms, then to the container world that we are in nowadays, and moving fast towards serverless, right? And which, as they say, is the future, right? The idea is the way we have evolved, right? From those data center days to containers and serverless world today, right? You don't need to spend too much capital. You don't need to spend too much manpower just to get your idea out in the market, right? You can just think of what problem you want to solve. You can code it out, and you can deploy it within seconds, right? There are a lot of managed services that can help you get your idea into the market within a matter of hours, right? But the bigger question here is, has that actually helped, right? Of course, right. It has reduced that barrier to come to the computer science world, but there has also been an explosion, right, in cloud technologies, right? And if you have not seen this image, this is CNCF landscape where they track all the projects that are related to cloud-native technologies, right? And that ecosystem is growing, right? This is a bit, I guess this is a bit older image. There are a lot of new things that have come up, and the situation is that if you want to get started, right, you need an interactive map just to understand what do all these things do, right? And I'm not even talking about scale here, right? When you reach at that level, it becomes a completely different ball game, right? So the way things have become easier, but the complexity or the onboarding experience has also become more complicated, right? There is a need, or there is an expectations, right, of making things easier, making things faster, and making things more flexible, right? If you look at the slide, right, every developer or every entrepreneur, right, goes through a journey, right? They usually start with something small as an hobby or something like that, and then they move on to create an SMB or a small business out of it, and then they move on to the enterprise part, right? Now, we as a company don't want to focus on the enterprise part, right? Because there are a lot of providers that are ready to do that, and there is a full-blown feature war going on out there, right? Everybody wants to have a full bouquet of managed services, right? And that just adds more complexity for individual developers and SMBs, right? The ask from those from that particular group, right, is to reduce that complexity and help them get their idea out there as soon as possible, right? And that's what our mission is, right? We want to make modern application creation simple and economical for millions of developers around the world, right? And that's what gives us more than 65 NPS, right? That's one of the top among all cloud providers, right? And that's just a testimonial from one of the developers. You can send, I mean, it's pretty fast and easy to use DigitalOcean. You can just set all the assets. You can get started with a production grade application, you know, probably under than 10, under 10 minutes as well. And as you saw on the last slide, right, the enterprise developers in a race to chase enterprise developers, the individual and the SMB groups becomes underserved, right? And we want to overcome that barrier, right? We want to super serve them, right? And we do that with simplicity, right? We focus that our services should be intuitive and simple to use, right? We focus on our community, right? Our community is larger than us. We want to help them in any way possible, right? We want to provide a free service for everybody, right? We have a great support team that works 24/7 to help developers all across the globe. And then we love open source, right? And it's not just that we use open source in our product offerings. We also contribute back to them. We also, you know, be it in terms of sponsorships, be it in terms of contributions, be it in terms of bug fixing or anything else, right? And we also have a marketplace where we can host open source applications, right? So if you are an open source developer who is building, you know, who is solving a niche problem and you want your solution to reach millions of developers around the globe, we have a place for you where you can host your application. And we love open source, right? And one of the core part of open source is community, right? We have a world-class leading community experience. We have a community site where we host more than 4 million unique visitors per month. We have got more than 2,000 technical tutorials. And just to mention that these tutorials are not specifically DigitalOcean related, right? These are generic tutorials, right? That anybody or on any tech topic, right? Anybody can go and read about them and get help on it, right? We have got more than 20,000 community generated questions and answers. And before COVID hit us, we had a huge meetup program where we supported meetup organizers and contributors among the world, right? And one of the biggest testament of DigitalOcean's commitment to community is Hacktoberfest. I'm just going to talk a bit about that. If you have not heard about Hacktoberfest, it's an October-long celebration of open source software, where individuals can learn, they can contribute, they can meet other developers, and they can contribute 4 pull requests to earn a limited edition t-shirt, right? And we started Hacktoberfest 6 years back with GitHub, and I guess in 2014, right? This is going to be the 6th edition. And since the way Hacktoberfest has grown, right, it has helped lot of developers, the open source community, to get started, right? There are a lot of people out there who are just thinking, how do we get started with the open source, right? How do I start contributing? Where should be my first PR, right? Hacktoberfest gives you that kickstart, right, to get started with open source, right? And it's not just for the individuals, right? It's also for the project owners, project maintainers, right? And there are a lot of project maintainers who are always looking for help, right? And they can advertise their project via Hacktoberfest, and they can get a lot of help from millions of developers, right? And of course, you get a limited edition t-shirt as well, right? That's just a bonus on top of all the learnings and all the mentoring you get, right? This year, we have this t-shirt design, right? We have a dark mode, light mode kind of thing going on. And we also have an option of, if you don't want to get a t-shirt, you can also, we will donate on your behalf to a charity, and they will put up a plan, right, for you. Just to give you an idea of how big Hacktoberfest is, right? When we started in 2014, we had 676 signups, right? And till last year, we had more than 130,000 signups, right? And that's gonna grow, you know, manifold this year as well, right? If you look at the terms of PRs, in 2015, we had like 49,000 PRs, and by 2019, we had more than 480,000 PRs, right? So this is the scale that is growing. That Hacktoberfest is growing on, right? And I guess when we started, we just had GitHub as a partner, but now we have got multiple partners on board, right? And everybody is helping us to reach out to the community, to help the open source community as well, right? If you want to be part of Hacktoberfest, please feel free to go to hacktoberfest.com and you can find all the relevant details there. Coming back to other programs, right? We have a lot of open source sponsorships, right? Like CNCF, Linux Foundation, Apache, right? Open Source Initiative, right? We have got good partnerships with them and they are sponsorships in terms of money, in terms of contributions, in terms of bug fixes, right? Multiple things, right? In terms of partnerships, etc. This is one of the programs that I wanted to highlight, right? This is called Hub for Good. And we started this when COVID crisis hit us all. And we wanted to provide a platform to developers or to entrepreneurs across the globe who are working on solutions related to COVID crisis, right? We had committed $100,000 in credit, $50,000 to the relief fund, right? And it's not just about the money and the credit parts, right? We also provide you a platform. We also provide you technical expertise. We also provide you a growth platform where you can grow your idea, where you can grow your startup. We will be able to, you know, we also help you nurture your idea, right? And we have done it to a lot of projects, right? And it could be anything, right? It could be as small as creating a scanner or a tracker, or it could be something as creating a complicated platform where people with special abilities want to access information about COVID-19, right? So if you are the developer who is creating, who has an idea of creating a platform based on COVID-19, please feel free to apply for this program. And we have got several other programs as well. We have Hatch for startups, right? Where we provide them a year-long worth of credits and also provide them nurturing, both on technical front and also on the development front, on the growth front, right? We have Write for Donation programs where you can write tutorials for DigitalOcean, and I know you get paid for that. We also donate to a charity on your behalf. Right? We also sponsor Open Collective initiatives where we sponsor a lot of open source projects. Right? And there are multiple things as well. We have GitHub pages where we sponsor, where we have open sourced a lot of our internal tools that our teams used. We have got programs where if you want to teach a computer science class and you are looking for some help in terms of credits and all those things, that all we can do for you, right? So that's all I had. I'd love to be here. Thank you for being a brilliant audience, and please get in touch. You have the LinkedIn and Twitter there, and if you want to send an email, please feel free to do that as well. And if you would like to try out DigitalOcean, you can just go to the link given do.co/Piyush. P is capital there. Or you can go to do.co/FOSS. That's the link you would have gotten in your email. And you can get $300 credits. And you can use them to try it out. Thank you for having me.